Granulomatous inflammation. How many months of treatment is required in tuberculosis?
6 months.
How many months of treatment is required in fungal infections, internal organs? 6 to 8 weeks. The common denominator between the two is long-term treatment because both types of microorganisms are very hard to eliminate from the body. So there is no enzyme system that is capable of digesting what component of the cell wall of the fungi? Chitin. So that is why a chronic type of granulomatous inflammation, a non-granulomatous type of chronic inflammation will develop in fungal infection. So ideally, we should be able to see granulomatous inflammation surrounding fungal spores and hyphae. Try naman ang pen kita. Ito na ang camera detector. What is your diagnosis in the alveoli pointed? Yes. No congestion of pores in the blood vessel. Mucus is seen in the airways, not in the bronchi and bronchioles only. We are looking at alveolar spaces. Okay, they are filled with fluid. What is the diagnosis for that pulmonary edema? That is what happens in pulmonary edema. That is why a patient with congestive heart failure will die if the heart failure is not properly treated, because that condition will eventually develop. Can you still remember why edema will develop? If there is left-sided heart failure. Okay, increased hydrostatic pressure in the capillaries of the lungs. So eventually, the wall of the blood vessel will not be able to hold water anymore because of the increased hydrostatic pressure exerted by the accumulated volume of blood. Okay. Slide number 98, please. Histoplasmosis is also a fungus. Anong sabi sa anong sumanuan may makita natin? Okay, granulomatous inflammation. What is the microscopic characteristic of the granulomatous inflammation? Giant cell. Uh-huh. Those are lymphocytes with small without confused and scanned cytoplasm and all those cells. They are the characteristic infiltrates in granulomatous inflammation. They appear almost similar with the squamous cells. Epitheloid macrophages. What is the other name for the epitheloid macrophages? The activated macrophages. So there is a focus of granulomatous inflammation, which means be secondary to the histoplasma capsulatum infection. Unfortunately, again, It will require a special type of stain in order to demonstrate fungal elements. Maybe PAS, pag wala yung diagnostic feature, unfair na ilang pasensya.
So, wala ko lang. Wala ako.
Slide number 135.
If
it aspirate on the molar. 135. Unfortunately, lipid will not take any of the stains used in the preparation of this slide, HNA level stains at all. So that we will not be able to see lipid particles. However, I'm not sure I have a breakout. Fat globules. And then you are seeing nuclei. Those nuclei are the nuclei of what cells? Amas. Lipid. Hindi adipose tissue ang na-aspirin dito lipids na. Macrophages. So they will now, because of the appearance of their cytoplasm, they should be properly called foamy cells or foamy macrophages. They have already phagocytosed the aspirated lipids. So that is the characteristic. Microscopic field that you should be able to see in order to come up with the diagnosis of lipid aspiration. And then other problems that will develop in lipid aspiration, kasi, well, how do you define aspiration? Kasama din na ma-aspirate ang bacteria from the oral cavity. Okay? Kasama din na ma-aspirate ang bacteria from the oral cavity. In the oral cavity, these bacteria are commensals. They do not produce any abnormality or they may be associated with the development of dental caries. So however, when they reach the lungs, because the lungs, it's not their normal habitat, they will become pathogens. So that is why we will be able to see, as described in your manual, areas of abscess formation. So because of the presence of millions of bacteria in the saliva, in the oral cavity. Anyway, come up with the diagnosis of lipid aspiration pneumonia, you should be able to see that field. Okay, the alveolar spaces are filled with lipid-laden macrophages. Slide number 29. Good postures is an example of inflammation of the blood vessels, inflammatory condition of the blood vessels. So, we have already examined this. Walang makitang vasculitis dito, sir. Should be able to see vasculitis, inflammation of the blood vessel wall, in order to come up with the diagnosis of good postures. This will then also come up in the hour after. Okay, so the
silicosis,
how about the tumors? Have we been in this? cell carcinoma, adenocarcinoma, small cell carcinoma.
Here,
silicosis is also inflamed with fibrosis on the edge also. Okay? So you may answer anaposis or silicosis for this slide.
Aside from that, another problem that will develop in asthma is this.
Kaya mayroong coughing din sa asthma because coughing is a reflex action of our airways in the attempt to eliminate anything that is obstructing the movement of the airway. So, what is the chemical responsible, major chemical responsible in the development? Okay, histamine. Histamine comes from, is it this, like what is that?
Mast cell.
So what stimulates the mast cell to release the contents of the granules? IgE. So IgE, which when IgE is found by the specific allergen that has triggered the formation of